Let's try to solve this problem together. Determine the intervals of continuity for the following piecewise function. F of x equals x squared plus 2 if x is less than or equal to 0, and 2x plus 5 if x is greater than 0. Okay, so we want to determine the intervals of continuity for this function. So first of all, what are my two basic pieces that are making up this piecewise function? Well, I've got x squared plus 2. So that's a quadratic function. It's a polynomial. So I know that that piece just in itself is continuous. So what's my other piece? 2x plus 5. Well, that's just a line. Also, you can think of it as a polynomial, 2x plus 5. So I know that also that equation, just in itself, is continuous. So the only place I have to worry about this function being not continuous is where these pieces join up at x equals 0. So to give ourselves a little bit of intuition about this problem, let's actually go over and graph it. Graphing can often be pretty helpful for piecewise functions, especially in cases like this where the two pieces are pretty simple. So let's take a minute to graph this. Okay, so I have a graph set up here already. So let's start with the x squared plus 2 piece. So this piece is defined if x is less than or equal to 0. So I'm going to start at 0 and then go to the left from there. Okay, so at 0, I plug in 0, I get 0 squared plus 2, so that's 2. So I'm going to put a closed dot here just to signify that that endpoint is included in this part of the piecewise function. Okay, so what about negative 1? So negative 1 squared gives me 1 plus 2 is 3. So I'm here. Negative 2, that's going to give me 4 plus 2, so 6. We'll do one more. Negative 3 is going to give me 9 plus 2, so 11 here at negative 3. And we get the idea. So we've got a parabola going up like this. Okay, what about my other piece? 2x plus 5. So this piece is defined if x is greater than 0. So it's not, this piece isn't actually defined at 0, but I'm going to go ahead and calculate what it would be and then put an open dot there. That'll just help us connect our piecewise graph together. So if I plugged in 0 to this function, I would get 5. So I'm going to put an open dot at 5. And then I'm going to continue to the right. So if I plug in 1, let's see, that's going to give me 2 plus 5, so 7. If I plug in 2, that's going to give me 4 plus 5, so 9. Okay, and that's enough. This is just a line, so we just need a few points. Okay, so this is what my piecewise function looks like. So graphing it like this, I can see clearly that it's not continuous at 0. But we're trying to find the interval over which it's continuous, so we need to be careful about what's happening at 0. What we really want to do is to determine if at 0, the function is continuous from the left or from the right or both. Now, just by looking at the graph, it looks to me like the function would be continuous from the left at 0. And the reason I say that is because if I imagine traveling along the function from the left, so I'm on this piece and here I am traveling along, I mean, 0 is kind of included in that piece. So it looks like I would consider this to be continuous from the left as I go to 0. I mean, what about from the right? Now, if I'm coming from the right, when I get to 0, I come to this open dot. So this piece isn't even defined at 0. So I would say just by looking at the graph, this doesn't look like it's continuous from the right at 0. But to say for sure, we actually need to write out the limits. Okay, so let me go back to this first page and we'll work those limits out there. Okay, just as a review, I'm going to quickly write down a summary of the definitions of continuous from the left and continuous from the right. So something is continuous from the left if the limit as x approaches a from the left of f of x equals f of a. And it's continuous from the right if the limit as x goes to a from the right of f of x equals f of a. So this looks like what we saw in our just general definition of continuity, except instead of looking at the limit as a whole, we're just looking at the limit from the left and the limit from the right. But we're still trying to see if the limit equals the function value. Okay, so let's apply this to our function. We want to see if at zero, the function is continuous from the left, continuous from the right, both, neither. So let's start with continuous from the left. So I need to calculate the limit as x goes to zero from the left of f of x. Okay, so that's the limit as x goes to zero from the left. Now I want to make sure to pick the left-hand side of my piecewise function. So that's going to be x squared plus 2 in this case. Okay, so this is x squared plus 2 is just a continuous polynomial. So to evaluate the limit as x goes to 0 from the left, I'm really just plugging in 0. So this is going to get me 2. Okay, so what's f of 0? Let's compare. Well, f of 0 is 0 squared plus 2, which equals 2. So I see that the limit as x goes to 0 from the left equals the function value at 0. So this tells me that f of x is continuous from the left at x equals 0. Well, what about continuous from the right? So to figure out if it's continuous from the right, I need to check the limit as x goes to 0 from the right. Okay, so to do this limit, I need to use the right-hand side of the piecewise function, which was 2x plus 5. Okay, so 2x plus 5, once again, that's just a continuous line. So taking the limit as x goes to something, it's just going to be the same as plugging that value into the function. So it's going to be 2 times 0 plus 5, so that's 5. Well, what about the function value? What is f of 0? Well, we just set up above that f of 0 is 2. Because the piecewise function is defined at 0 to be x squared plus 2. So 0 squared plus 2, which equals 2. So these are not equal, right? The right-handed limit, which is 5, does not equal the function value, which is 2. So this means that this is not continuous from the right at x equals 0. So now that I've done all this work, I'm able to write down my final answer. And remember that I want to write down the intervals of continuity. So once again, note that x squared plus 2 and 2x plus 5 are both continuous functions in general. So the only place that I could have any sort of discontinuity is at x equals 0 here. So the first interval where my function is continuous is going to correspond to this x squared plus 2 piece of the function f of x. So I can say this is continuous on the interval from negative infinity to 0. Now remember, we discovered that this was continuous from the left, so I'm going to include 0 in this interval. But there's another interval where it's continuous, and that's the interval that's going to correspond to this 2x plus 5 piece. And so I've also got the interval from 0 to infinity. And notice that I'm not including 0 in the second piece, right? I'm using a parenthesis here because we determined that the function was not continuous from the right at 0.